I appreciate everybody's patience. I didn't actually want a little lengthy than what we anticipated. Ms. Roundtree, do you want to bring in any additional business this evening?
I do, Mr. Chairman. I understand that we have an attendance policy that is in effect, and we also have a member that's in violation of the attendance policy.
Yes, ma'am.
I would like to request by chairman that that be brought to the attention of the municipality that he does represent, and that perhaps alternate should be appointed.
We will address that. We also, I will make sure that I get with county on that to address that situation. I also have addressed directly, indirectly with the mayor of Dasher, that they have been, have a vacant seat for almost 5 years now, and to see if they want to get back on board with that, this money in. I know that we even discussed in our work session, I know that, Remington, Jessica has a petition going on, a petition with a letter trying that wants to be a formal part of this. So I know there was some discussion last week, Matt, that we want to do a 50-50. I don't know where we're at on that, or we could conceivably have three more seats up here in 2 months.
Well, for three more people.
Three more people, yes.
Or, well, two more people, one replacement.
That's correct.
Currently, this is officially, by practice, an 11-member commission. The current ordinance, that's a joint ordinance that establishes this commission, is actually 14 members. But the Planning Commission, starting about 15 years ago, voluntarily reduced that number through local government appointments down to the current 11. So going back from 11 to 12, and in Remington, is actually lower than where we were more than 15 years ago in terms of actual numbers. Jason and I talked about the logistics and the language of creating a new joint ordinance. Our agreement is to sort of use the 1996 ordinance as the template, then add in some things that were discussed by several of the member governments about 10 years ago. We hope to have a draft of that to you at your next meeting.
Do you know where we're at with the letter from Remington getting to the city and county fathers to see the acceptance of that?
We have the official letter of request and the resolution from the Remington City Council on file. Jason has a copy in citywide. So
does that have to go before the respective committees at that meeting, or is it something they do outside of that?
It's something I've at least notified city leadership of that informally. The process would be to bring the new draft ordinance to you for ratification and recommendation of approval to your 5-member governments. We would then put it on the agenda for the city councils and county commission of all 6-member, okay, proposed member governments, which is the exact same process we did in 1996. But we need to start with you, and I'm hoping to have it on your agenda for your March meeting, but we'll talk about it at the March work session. It's not an advertised public hearing, so we don't have to go through all of that ahead of time. So we could conceivably have it on the elected government agendas for April.
Okay, Jessica.
Mr. Chairman, it was a brief discussion last week about Remington having a rotating seat in conjunction with, say, for example, the city of Dasher. We would be willing to do that as well, if it would be easier for staff and for the commission to keep the 11 commissioners as is right now, instead of creating 12 seats for the commission, that we would be willing to do a rotating seat for the commission.
Well, I was just thinking, would this be an appropriate time to address the fact that we have had an empty seat for close to 5 years? So maybe address the fact that that seat has been empty, adding in Remington, and the fact that we have a member whose attendance has been poor of late.
It's something we can talk about at the work session. I think we need to open up a conversation with the city of Dasher about what they want to do going forward, and see if they would be willing to share a member. And if so, and we want to pursue that, then it's a matter of logistics of, currently a 5-year appointment terms. How do we split that between 2-member governments?
Looks like you're on top of it. We appreciate that. You and Jason always take care of us up here. So, commissioners, like I said, it's been a lengthy meeting. I apologize for that. But at this time, I will definitely entertain a motion to adjourn.
So move.